a dying Jesus hanging from a cross with a sign that reads, "The King of the Jews." Down below surrounds a large, obnoxious crowd of angry onlookers, weepers, and persecutors. He has been tried not twice, not three, but six times by different rulers, which two of them find him not guilty. And after being flogged, beaten, and ordered to carry this heavy, rugged cross, Jesus still finds strength to pray out to the Father, "Forgive them, for they know not what they are doing." Let's put a pinches right here. You see, a divine proclamation has just occurred in which Jesus is seen offering forgiveness towards his enemies as an act of unconditional love. It was here that Jesus is at the height of his demise. He's wounded in excruciating pain. His oppressors are still mocking him in spite of the denial and betrayal of two of his own followers. In spite of his own agony, Jesus never breaks. He never curses them. See, they were cruel, but Jesus was compassionate. They were fearful, but Jesus was faithful. And they were guilty, but Jesus was forgiving.
Yes.
Don't you know that in spite of your own personal disposition, God is still able to look past the dirt, the filth, and mistakes, and give you a pardon or forgiveness because you know
come on, Kendra.
Just like he did right here in the text, Jesus was able to look out at his oppressors from the cross. Jesus was able to look out into us in the future as sinners and orchestrate his forgiveness in a whisper of a prayer. Nevertheless, it was their unforgiveness towards Jesus for his public rejection of their laws and traditions that caused them to secretly plot and kill Jesus. They were too afraid to lose everything that they had. They were looking for the Mashiach, which is the human ruler who would come and restore Jerusalem. They weren't looking for the Mosiah or Savior by the name of Jesus. They were looking to keep their power and position. So instead, they allowed their unforgiveness towards Jesus to cause them to commit such a brutal, heinous crime. And though it caused Jesus to die a criminal's death, he still forgave them. What I'm trying to say tonight is, how can we be convinced that in an unforgiving world, Jesus forgives us for anything? Well, when we look at the text, it says that he speaks to the Father on our behalf. When we look back at the text, Jesus said, "Father, forgive them." Not, "Father, destroy them," but, "Father, forgive them." Here we see Jesus is speaking on our behalf when no one asked him to or petitioned him to. But because of his love, he did it anyhow. He shows us that in spite of our sin, he advocates for us when we can't or don't advocate for ourselves. That no matter what you do or how much you do, forgiveness is still here. How can we be convinced that in an unforgiving world, Jesus forgives us for anything? Well, it says in the text, he is aware of our deficiency. Right here, Jesus said, for they know not, see, because I know, but they know not what they are doing. I know that you may be lacking. I know that you ain't got it all together. I know you just can't get right. But because I am that I am. Because I got love, I can only see you through lenses of love, baby. Because when I look at you, I don't see a mess. I see the best. Is there anybody in this place that can say, "Thank you, God, for sending nothing but the best to me"? When the world only sees our shortcomings. When the world is too unforgiving. But I thank God for his unstraining love. I thank God for blessing me in spite of my deficiencies. On the hill called Calvary that gave us the greatest equation known to man. His name is Jesus. And this equation that has given us cannot be found in a computer or calculus.